Today I'm showing how to change Saab 9.3 gearbox oil in the GM 6-speed manual. Fluid change in this box is common across a whole world of GM cars and is applicable to all. From the factory, these boxes were filled with a Castrol manufactured oil designated 0063, and no fluid change was specified. They are filled for life. Be under no apprehension though that they will last forever without a fluid change, because the usual OEM definition of life is 10 to 12 years and 120 to 150,000 miles. About half of all boxes can be expected to suffer early life failure before that point. So stack the odds in your favour by changing the fluid at regular intervals. About every 50 or 60,000 miles with an engine in the 300 newton metre bracket would be my suggestion. But drop that to 30,000 miles if you've got an engine that's pushing the gearbox close to its rated 400 newton meter torque, or even above that. One of the defining features of this gearbox is that it does not have a side mounted fill and level plug. The fill plug is on the top of the gearbox. You can actually see it in this screen. I've got a socket located in it, and you will need an 8mm hex to undo that. If you've got a B207 petrol, same as this, then you can access the fill plug from above, down between the end of the engine and the battery tray. You will need a universal joint or a wobble joint to get your 8mm hex in there, and you'll need a pipe to be able to fill it up with. But if you've got a diesel or a V6, then you will need to remove the battery. I've done a video on how to remove the battery in the battery tray. I'll link to that in the description. The drain plug is, of course, at the bottom of the gearbox. Wouldn't be much point otherwise, would there? And you will need to raise the car to be able to access it and get your drain pan underneath. I'm using my ramps, which raise the height of the car approximately 4 inches, which is sufficient for the access that I need. And not too much height that it stops all of the oil coming out of the gearbox. Before going underneath and taking the drain plug out, remove the fill plug from the top of the gearbox. And yes, it is tight. If you've got any suspicions over the condition of the fill plug, or the drain plug for that matter, then obtain new ones before you start. But just to let you know, if you buy new ones from GM, the later versions of the fill and drain plugs come with a torx fitting. I don't actually know what size the torx fitting is, although I suspect it's a T50. And the drain plug also has a magnet in it. I don't know which year it was when they swapped over from hex to torx. The drain plug is near the rear leftmost corner of the gearbox. Again, undo that with your 8mm. Hopefully, like me, you'll find that once you've loosened it off, it'll come out easily by finger, and bring your drain pan into place and withdraw the drain plug all the way. Now it's time to go and get a cuppa as you leave the gearbox to drain all of its oil out. If you're doing this straight after putting the car on the ramps with the engine and gearbox warm, I would suggest leaving it for an hour. If you're doing it cold after the gearbox has already settled, you could probably leave it for a little less time, because the oil will have already gathered at the bottom. If you're working on a V6 or a diesel and you've removed the battery and the battery box, your funnel may well reach into the fill hole without any extra length. But you might need a short piece of hose, particularly if you're working on a B207 like I am. About a 400mm length, that's about 16 inches. The hose should be no more than 18mm in diameter. 16 is best, it slides in easily. 18 just squeezes in snugly, and funnel in the top. With the drain plug still out and your drain pan still below, just pour in about a quarter of a litre of your fresh oil and allow it to drain through, just like I've shown you when changing engine oil. Don't forget to put the drain plug back, and top tip, you will find it less of a stretch to get at the drain plug if you go in from behind the front left wheel. If you've got the car up on axle stands rather than ramps, it'll be even easier if you take the front left wheel off. In good light, inspect your old oil that you've just removed for any that little gold flecks floating on the surface of the oil, which would be brass parts. And the brass would come from the synchromesh. As it happens, there's absolutely nothing here, even less than last time I took it out. Now, the oil that I'm removing from the gearbox on this occasion is this Castrol Syntrans Multivehicle 75W90, which is what Castrol recommend for this gearbox. Bear in mind, of course, that Castrol made the original factory fill. This oil fill had a half dose of moly slip in it as well. I have to say, it massively improved the gear change, did seem to make the gearbox quieter. Now, I have previously tried this Redline MTL, which is a 70W80 GL4, but I found that wanting. It didn't improve the gear change at all, it didn't improve the noise at all, and I really didn't like it. If I remember rightly, I left it in for less than 20,000 miles. And then I changed from this Redline MTL to torx MTF. That was an improvement on the Redline, but not much really. So I subsequently changed to this Castrol, and like I say, I found that to be superb. I'm very, very pleased. I've done two fills now with the Castrol, but this time I'm going for Mannol Unigear. This is a 75W80. The specified oil fill is a 75W85 GL4. Whatever else you do, do not put GL5 in this box. I'll report how I get on with this in the comments. A word about fill quantity. In the early days when this gearbox was new and it first came out in the Saab 9.3, the Vectra C cousin and the Fiat Chroma cousin, they came filled from the factory with 3 litres. But somewhere around 2007, GM, through their various arms, Saab Wiz and Vauxhall with their technical bulletin system, they changed the quantity of the fill down to 2.4 litres. This was in response to difficult gear change, noise and other issues. Basically, they'd been overfilling the gearbox. So be sure to measure yourself out a quantity of 2.4 litres. However you measure that is up to you. I'm just going to put 2 1-litre tubs in and then measure out 0.4 of a litre. Pour the oil in gently, being sure, of course, that you have put the drain plug back in and torqued it up. You wouldn't be the first one to make that mistake. As previously mentioned, this gearbox doesn't have a fill and level plug. Therefore, the only way to be certain the gearbox has got the correct quantity of oil in is, in fact, to drain it completely and then refill with the correct quantity. And the final 0.4 of a litre that I've measured out. Remove your funnel and your fill tube. Don't forget to put the fill plug back on. I've found that I can actually start it off with my left hand, just using my forefinger and thumb. But don't forget to get your hex in it and tighten it back down. No need to go too mad. And all you need to do now is drop the car back on the ground and you're ready to go. If you got value from this video, please consider supporting the channel. And I shall see you on the next one.